Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to How the West Was Lost, the history of the Western. This is part two of our four-part series. This week, we are looking at Hollywood's golden age of Western films, so let's get right into it. So from 1930 to 1960, Westerns were the most popular genre that moviegoers attended. In today's landscape, our most popular genre is the comic book, where we have hundreds and hundreds of heroes in dire situations. But back then, audiences had the Western film. From the 1930s to 50s, Westerns were categorized as the classical period of the genre. Before the television had been invented, the first American hero had been created for a young generation of consumers.
The Lone Ranger.
The Lone Ranger was a masked vigilante and former Texas Ranger who fought outlaws in the old American West with his Native American friend Tonto. The Lone Ranger, since its radio release and later televised programs, has been called an enduring icon of American culture. In 1952, we got High Noon, a gunfighting black and white film starring Gary Cooper as a retired marshal who is waiting for a train of bandits to arrive, only to take them out one by one. High Noon takes place in real time. As the audience waits for the train at noon, so does the main character. High Noon is considered to be a classic of the genre and was selected for preservation by the National Film Registry for being culturally, historically, and aesthetically significant. The film also won four Academy Awards for its innovations of acting, musical score, and editing. Then, one year later, we received a film called Shane, which was shot in glorious Technicolor starring actor Alan Ladd.
I've heard about you. What have you heard, Shane? I've heard that you're a low-down Yankee liar.
The film tells the story of a nomadic gunman who rolls into town, saving the local farmer from a band of fighters. The film won an Oscar for Best Cinematography that year and is considered by the American Film Institute in being one of the top 100 best films of all time. So two of the most prolific figures during the classical Western period were John Ford and John Wayne. John Ford was an American director who directed features such as The Grapes of Wrath, Stagecoach, The Searchers, and The Man Who Shot Liberty Valance. John Ford is most famous for his use of wide shots and his use of color. He loved shooting scenes against the setting sun, as characters were often silhouetted from the darkness. He was also one of the very first directors who shot at very famous Western locations, one of them being Monument Valley, located in Arizona. Another key figure during the classical Western was John Wayne. John Wayne, like the Lone Ranger, is considered to be an American icon. Born Marion Robert Morrison, he later adapted the stage name John Wayne, also known as the Duke. John Wayne was a box office draw for three decades, and he epitomized rugged masculinity and is famous for his demeanor, especially his distinctive, calm voice, walk, and height. John Wayne's career exploded when he starred in John Ford's Western Stagecoach. He also famously played drunk Marshall Rooster Cogburn in True Grit, and is most famous for his portrayal as a Civil War veteran searching for his abducted niece in the John Ford classic The Searchers. Film critic Roger Ebert said this about The Searchers. He said that John Wayne's character was one of the most compelling characters that Ford and Wayne ever created on screen. The Searchers has that signature Ford Western feel and is considered to be one of the greatest American films of all time. So taking on a much darker approach to the Western genre, director John Huston made Treasure of the Sierra Madre, starring Humphrey Bogart, Tim Holt, and Walter Huston. The film is about two deadbeats who employ a guide to search for gold in the nefarious Sierra Madre Mountains in western Mexico. The film depicts a post-revolutionized Mexican government showing bandits and federales. The film is often described as a story about the corrupting influence of greed. Bogart's character, Fred Dobbs, is considered by many film historians to be one of the most corruptible and despicable characters ever written on screen.
Cards are dealt the other way now, and for the last time, no more shuffling.
What cards are you talking about?
I'm going to finish this right now. No more taking orders from you like I had to do today, get me?
You mean you're going to murder me?
Oh, brother, not murder, no. Your mistake. I'm doing this to save my life, that you'd be taken from me the minute I wasn't looking at you.
The old man will catch up with you.
Oh, he will he? Well, I got an answer for that one, too. You know what I'm going to tell him? I'm going to tell him you tied me to a tree and made your getaway, taking all the goods, yours, mine, and his, so they'd be looking for you and not me. Up, march. Today I had to march to your music, now you'll march to mine.
Where?
To your funeral.
Treasure of the Sierra Madre was also one of the first Hollywood films that shot outside of the United States. The movie is considered to be a classic and was selected for preservation by the National Film Registry. Its dark themes of greed, nature, and the corruption of man inspired Italian director Sergio Leone to craft a new breed of Western films that forever changed the Western genre. Anyway, that's it for us today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video of the classical era of Western films. Next week, we're getting more into the Clint Eastwood films and the spaghetti Westerns, so stay tuned for that. If you like this video, click the like button over here. Also, make sure to subscribe to this channel. Also, check out our website, filmschoolhooligans.com, and we will see you guys next week. See you then.